The federal funds rate, the interest rate that banks charge each other for overnight loans. It effectively acts as the base rate of interest for the United States, and its effects can ripple across the US and beyond. When the Fed funds rate is low, US banks tend to borrow more money from each other and reduce the interest rates they charge to commercial and retail clients. This lowers the cost of borrowing for businesses and consumers, who normally respond by borrowing and spending more. The economy then grows, and we ultimately see a rise in inflation. Savers sometimes react directly to low interest rates too. They may move their money out of bank accounts in the hope of receiving better returns elsewhere. This can increase demand for bonds, stocks, and commodities, driving the price of these assets up. Others may look to invest their money overseas, which decreases demand for the US dollar and lowers its value against other major currencies. This can have knock-on effects for major exporters such as China, India, and the EU. As their currencies increase in value against the dollar, their exports to the US effectively become more expensive. Exports from the US, however, become more attractive. This can ultimately hamper GDP growth in these countries. The result for developing nations is often much better. Many of these countries sell commodities that are traded in dollars. They'll benefit from increased demand for these assets, which drives prices up and boosts GDP. These countries also often borrow in dollars, so a devalued dollar makes their debts easier to repay. So what happens if the federal funds rate goes up? As you'd expect, a raised rate can have the opposite effect. US banks may borrow less money from each other and increase the interest rates they charge to commercial and retail clients. This, in turn, increases the cost of borrowing for businesses and consumers, who respond by borrowing less. They also tend to save more, as they can receive better returns on their deposits. This can result in less spending, lower economic growth, and reduced inflation. Investors may look to sell their assets and move their money into bank accounts in the US. This can increase demand for the dollar, raising its value against other major currencies. Once again, the effects may spread globally. Major economies can benefit as the cost of exports to the US fall and US goods become more expensive and less competitive globally. We may then see GDP growth in these countries. It's not such good news for developing nations. A higher Fed funds rate lowers demand for commodities, which in turn lowers their prices. National debt can also increase as the dollar strengthens, making it more difficult to repay. This can mean lower economic growth and higher debt for these countries. It's important to bear in mind that this is just an introduction to the relationship between the US Fed funds rate and global economies. The relationship is complex with many contributing factors, and the effects of a rate change can take 18 months to 2 years to trickle through the global economy. To learn more about trading, join IG Academy. To start trading, open an account.